Angel 7, taxi single Hornet for 0+45 media ride. Like to coordinate a runway 8 departure and unrestricted climb at 10,000 feet.
Runway 8's approved and VFR climb out at pilot's discretion.
Angel 7, thank you.
Call me a joker.
What?
Call me a fool.
What?
Right at this moment I'm totally calm.
What?
Clear as a crystal, sharp as a knife.
Mike, you're telling me that the hair has to be cut like that?
Relax.
I mean, it's very aerodynamics or something?
I think if you're going to be a Blue Angel for the day, you got to look the part. Thanks for trusting me there, Kevin.
Many people get the chance to do it, to go mock and cruise over at 600 miles an hour about 50 feet off the ground, fly upside down. It's a ride of a lifetime.
We'll go ahead and do what we call a high performance unrestricted climb on takeoff, and I guarantee you that'll light your hair on fire right on the start.
Hi, my name's Captain Ken Hopper.
I'm Captain Scott Larson.
And this next song is a favorite of my fiancée, Candace. It's Dreams by Van Halen.
I like a wide range of music. I think MTV is real good about that.
Most everybody on the long flights carries a Walkman, would you? With the little headphones that can fit inside the headsets we wear.
Set up for the F-18. We're putting a peanut camera in the back seat of the 7-jet so you can film and listen to what's going on in the back seat. They're going to see him turn into basically, it's going to be a Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde look. He's going to turn into an elongated skeleton. His face is going to go from being pulled down to his neck to being pushed up into his eyelids.
Yeah, we'll get higher, higher, straight up the climb.
Fellas, I'm going to give you a pre-flight brief. I'm going to tell you what to expect during your flight in your jet. Right.
Mm-hmm. Flight. What? Everybody, Don Strahan, crew chief of number seven, lucky right. number seven. And he's going to lay bare the secrets of what awaits me in the air. Okay.
Right.
So I get in the... Okay.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. First of all, I need to know how you're feeling today.
Hot. Strong.
Hot. Great. All right.
Hard.
You're not having any problems with your sinuses or anything? No, you can breathe. That's good to go. All right, your head moves.
Fine.
What you're going to experience is the G's in the jet, okay? One G is one times your body weight. So if you're pulling six G's, it's six times your body weight pushing onto you, okay? First time you're going to experience that is out here on the takeoff. He's going to do his high-performance climb, okay? What he's going to do, he's going to just run down the runway 50 feet off the deck, get up to a certain speed, and just...
Snap it up.
Pull the stick back towards them, and you're going to be going up about 45 degrees or more, you know. And you'll end up experiencing about six and a half G's, somewhere in there. Okay, anytime the pilot's going to pull over three G's, he's going to say, stand by, stand by, pull.
Stand by, stand by, pull.
Stand by, stand by, pull.
When he says pull, tighten every muscle up in your body, especially your abdomen and legs. That'll help you the most. Take a nice deep breath real quick and down real hard.
And that helps me to keep the blood
keep
in.
The blood what going, right?
Boom! There we go!
Any discomforts in your whole body, let the pilot know.
All right.
He needs to know that. It's very
okay.
important.
I mean, it would sound great. Oh, I ruptured my eardrums flying
yeah.
with the Blue Angels. But it just, well, it wouldn't sound, it might sound great to someone else. It wouldn't sound like anything to me.
I don't think they'd buy it, though. If he calls for any emergencies, just listen to him.
Okay.
Don't ask him any questions or anything. He'll take care of it. If he mentions eject, what I need you to do is take your feet. They'll be sitting out on the rudders.
Right.
I need you to pull them back to your seat, put them flat on the floor. Take your arms, cross your body, grab your harness. Take your head and put it against the back of the seat. Just sit there. Keep your arms tight against your body, though. There
tight
you go.
Against the body.
That's right.
Make sure everything is out of the way.
Right. You don't want to
so
be flopping out. Right.
A piece of equipment with me.
Right. That's the ticket right there.
And then
so you just
then,
want to sit back and just he'll take care of everything. You don't have to pull
I don't have to pull
any
yellow and black handles.
Nope.
I don't have to punch any yellow and black
you
buttons.
Have to touch
I
it.
Never ever touch anything that's yellow and black.
Nope.
That's the rule.
Any questions, comments, or concerns?
Oh, it sounds really, really good. It sounds like I can hardly wait to get out there and do it, actually.
Well, let's do it then.
Let's do it then? All right. Next time that you see me, Kevin Seale's Sporting Fool, I'll be in a multi-million dollar FA-18 Hornet with a Blue Angel. Let's go.
Driving to the corner for some milk. Here's the cost. Emissions.
All right, we'll have fun.
Engine fire right. Engine fire right.
Okay, clear canopy. Clear. Great, canopy's coming down.
Wind calm altitude 3021, push up to -300.
Okay, since you're going to be flying the airplane, go ahead and grab a feel of that stick and move it around, just like I did.
Landing departing runway 26, control zone closed until 1330.
What's it feel like being strapped in an F-18?
Oh, it's making me flutter.
Okay, we just...
I want my MTV.
Now, who was that?
Tower, Blue Angel 7. Blue Angel 7, takeoff 1, I'm restricted to 10. Blue Angel 7, clear, thanks.
Okay, what we're going to do is just like we talked about there, Ken. We're going to get up there on the runway. We're going to run the power up to military power. You're going to feel the airplane squat. Then I'll come off the brakes. We'll accelerate a little bit. Then I'll say, burners ready now. We'll kick in the burners. You'll feel them slide off the stage and then kick in the pants as we accelerate. We'll climb to 50 feet. Level transition at 50 feet. And towards the end of the runway at 300 knots, we'll say standby, standby, full. And we'll go ahead and look from the earth from behind us.
Great.
Flight 07 will be airborne in 30 seconds.
To the world.
Okay, it's really getting tense. We're in the jet, we're about to take off. And this puts me in the mind of that Bon Jovi video where right in the middle of the song they fly up in the air and fly around. This is it. This is Living on a Prayer from Bon Jovi. When we come back, I'm going to be screaming down that runway.
We'll be right back.
like the Eagles, better than the Eagles. We're ready to rocket into the sky. I'm set, John.
Okay, Kevin, stand by for a ride with Blue Angel 7. There's a throttle coming up. Now you feel a throttle come up. Feel the airplane squat. The noise right. Thunders. Off brakes now. There's acceleration. Stand by the burners. Burners ready now. You feel the afterburners light up. We're already at 100 miles per hour. There's 120, 130, 140. We're going flying.
Oh, yes.
We're airborne. Gears coming up.
Back oh, coming up. The way. We're off the ground.
50 feet, 230 knots, 250, 260, 270, 300. Stand by. Stand by. Pull. There we go.
Oh, Lord, look what the earth is doing.
And if you look down on your right side there, you'll see the field just getting smaller.
So long. Farewell. I'll be the same. Oh, it's farm country around here, huh?
It sure is. And we're still accelerating over 200 miles per hour.
Oh, great.
And there we are, passing 8,000 feet. I'll just roll her over here on the left.
We're looking straight down now.
And Charles, that's 175.
There was a field we just left. A little bit smaller now, huh?
Hi, everybody. That's a really small field.
not a bad way to start your day, is it?
Oh, look at this. Oh, way above the smoke from all the field burning, everything up here. The Imperial Valley, miracle in the desert.
Tower Blue Angel 7 is clear. Thanks for the help.
You 7, Roger.
Okay, what we're going to do is I'm going to call up what they call Shade Tree Target here and see if we can work that area.
Shade Tree Target, Blue Angel 7.
Blue Angel 7, I'm hot this time.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, what we'll do is I'm going to call up Range Control here and we're going to find an area we can go play around in. So what'd you think of that takeoff?
Oh, that was great.
Stand by.
How many G's do you think you pulled?
What was that? I didn't see. 5?
5.6.
5.6?
Yeah.
Great.
Take control of this fighter and fly me around. You want to switch roles?
Yes, I'd like that very much.
Okay, I'm going to, first off, just go ahead and grab the stick there.
Got a hold of it here.
Grab your left hand on the throttles.
All right.
Okay, you're in control.
Just like that. I'm flying a Navy Blue Angels FA-18 Hornet. What do you think of that?
Okay, you can go ahead and roll us out straight and level now. A little more power. Push the nose down a little. Good. Yeah, that's straight and level. No, back left.
All right.
Okay, and just get settled down here.
Yeah, there's a little bit of an arc to that, I understand.
You want to know where the horizon is at all times.
Okay, the horizon is my friend because that's where the earth is.
There you go. So go ahead now, pull the stick back a little bit. It's about 8 to 10 degrees nose up.
All right.
Now put in a left-hand turn, roll. There you go. Keep it coming. Keep it coming.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Not bad. That's all you.
I just made the plane do that. Oh. Oh, yes. Now I got to come over the top there a little bit. Oh, yes. I can see why somebody might be interested in doing this as a career.
Oh, I bet you can.
Can we try that one more time?
Sure can. You can do
all
it
right.
Faster if you want.
All right. Pull the nose up to about 8 or 10 degrees there.
Yep, go ahead.
And just, all right, here we go.
Okay.
Coming up, and I'm going to put in right out. Not bad. Oh, yes. Boy, to have control of a piece of machinery like this, to be just at the peak of one's form, like Lieutenant Foley, a Navy demonstration pilot like that is about as top of the line as you can get. It's a glamour boy kind of thing to do. We got living color right now here with glamour boys. There's the world.
But you know, Kevin, we don't like to think ourselves as glamour boys. We're more professional.
The glamour boys, swear they are diva. The glamour boys have it all under control. Always dancing, always laughing. The glamour boys are playing the role. Glamour boys never have the money. The glamour boys wear the most expensive clothes. The glamour boys are always at the party where the money comes from. Heaven only knows. The glamour boys have it all figured out. A very, very dubious position when you got no cloud. The glamour boys know life is a gamble. They might get over a far flat on the face. But if one does, there's no need to worry. Another G won't take his place.
Okay, Kevin, you ready to go almost the speed of sound?
Let's take it right up there.
Tell you what, see those throttles on the left here that are moving?
Right, the big black things?
Yeah, why don't you grab those?
All right, I got them.
Go ahead and push them up to the firewall. You'll feel them stop. There you go, now you just plugged in the burner.
Oh, I feel the fuel flying out.
We're already at 350 knots, 0.57. Here comes 400. You can feel it starting to vibrate now.
Oh, yeah, it's starting to kick a little bit. 450,
there you go.
480.
Oh, 500. Feel the wind coming. Here comes the vibrations. 0.83 back. 560. 0.89. 0.9. 600. 0.93. 0.95. 0.96. 0.98. 630 knots.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you can see the field down there. I'm going to call the tower. Let them know we're coming in. Okay, 1, 2, 3,
rock.
Flaps full. Hooks up. Harsh lock. Spencer ejects slick. We're ready to land. Well, that's what it feels like with the ride with Blue Angel 7.
And this is something you do every day.
Every day, three times a day.
7 days a week?
6 days a week.
6 days a week,
we sometimes get a day off.
It's very generous of the Defense Department. And there we are, back on the ground again. Just like that. Oh, Lieutenant Foley, that was an amazing excursion.
Well, good, I enjoyed it, Kevin. You're a good passenger.
Well, I'm almost tongue-tied. Let me shake your hand again, and let me repeat, it's the most amazing thing that I've ever done. And if you get a chance to do it, you'll either be, I guess, probably in the media like me, just trying to, you know, squeeze a little something off of our taxpayers, or you'll be defending our country like this man, and either way, you're lucky, you're proud. So, well, thank you very much, and I guess I'll go, I gotta go sit down someplace.
Yeah. You did well.
Kevin, you still have that need?
Don, that need has been met.